he's up to 202 3/4. Many feel he's most effective at this weight.
Them body shots are going to take his toll in the later rounds if it goes that far.
McDonough, a senior at St. John's University, where he majors in English and supports a 3.8 grade point average. Law school may be in his future.
Right now, he's got to use some of that law to keep the country boy off him, because the country boy now is starting to put pressure on. And you see Coleman, another good hook to the body. Made Sheamus double over.
Oh, nice counter by Sheamus McDonough. Country boy Cecil Coffey is doing nice body work. A couple of those punches are borderline low blows.
What a good jab by Coffey. Steps in, he puts all his weight behind it. All 197 pounds.
Good counter there by McDonough. And a counter by Coffey.
This guy Coffey, this country boy is tough.
When Murphy Griffith got a hold of Coffey, he weighed 239 pounds late 1987. He's been down as low as 194, and for this fight, he's at 197.
Well, he was blessed, you know. They say good things come to those who wait, and after everything that happened, he came across Murphy Griffith.
Second round comes to a close as we work, and look at Sheamus McDonough.
Standard. A little weave in the chapter and work the jab, all right? Okay, Sheamus?
Okay.
All right. Now, don't try too much with that right hand. Take this spot, you'll get it. You try a little weaving, take your time, and you jab, you jab with it. Jump, boom. Work the jab. Get it together.
Am I winning?
Yes.
Just keep it more steady. Keep it more steady.
That's the voice of the thin man, Nick Baffy, his manager. What is he looking for, buddy, the jab?
Yeah, that's what he wants Sheamus to do. And I think that's what he has to do. Jab, you know, when Coffey jabs, or even jab before Cecil Coffey jabs, in order to offset Cecil Coffey. Because right now, Coffey's establishing his jab very well.
You didn't think Coffey was big at the weigh-in this morning.
Nah, he had his shirt on, but then when he took it off, I see.
He's got a very big upper body. And after he got on the scale this morning, he raised his hands triumphantly to all of the members of the press and the other fighters that were in attendance. He looked confident.
Well, I guess you do when you get the good trainer behind. Like I said, when you know you work hard in the gym and you're in great shape, this is easy. It becomes a party. But like they're having a rough party, though.
Round number three, scheduled for 10. Coffey landing the jab. Boy, Coffey really zips those jabs.
He's surprising me with his jab. I'm surprised with his hand speed. Now, when you hear country boy, you expect this one to come straight at you and barreling behind both arms, but.
Good counter by Sheamus McDonough.
Country boy landed a good right hand. I think Sheamus should do what his corner's telling him is to box him.
Head to head, the two fighters right now. There's a jab that landed squarely.
Sheamus has a good jab, and he should jab with Cecil Coffey like Nick Baffy told him.
Sheamus answering with the right, and Sheamus doing most of his best work with that right hand.
Now he's countering like Baffy told him, counter his jab. He's catching it, he should also counter when he catches it.
Coffey with a stiff jab. Good opportunity there for McDonough to counter. He just missed. Solid body blow dug in there by Cecil Coffey.
These are two very good prospects.
McDonough lands. McDonough has been very patient, buddy.
Yes, he's come with experience. You know, he's learning with every fight. He's more patient now.
McDonough just winked at us at ringside, so he feels he's in command, and he's certainly composed if he's got the time to wink.
Well, he's using all the stuff now from law school. He's using all the knowledge from school now.
McDonough backed up by another big body blow by Coffey. pacing himself a little bit. I really do.
We know he's in for a long evening, so he's going to pace himself. And
you're watching professional boxing from Atlantic City.
Call 463-4300 to order.
Brent's Cecil Coffee McDonough in the green trucks and Coffee in the black and white trucks. Thought McDonough bought a good last minute of the third round.
Oh, yeah.
These guys are letting it all hang out.
I think the two most important things, determination and condition, are going to win this fight.
Fans are enjoying it. There's nothing quite like a heavyweight bout when there is some action.
Yep. These guys are starting like Kevin Kelly and Barella did.
Oh, a crushing right hand landed by Coffee.
He's been timing Sheamus with it. But Sheamus has been countering with a good left hook, though.
Coffee digs the body blow. Soft right hand to the button. McDonough didn't really feel that blow.
He's working the body like Coffee.
Now McDonough counters. McDonough trying to set up that big right hand of his, which is his potent weapon, that powerful right cross. Sheamus turned pro in 1985 in Atlantic City. This is his fourth full season. He lost only once to Mike Peek, and that was back in 1988 when Peek ran all night and frustrated McDonough. Tonight he doesn't have that same worry because Coffee is right in front of him.
And Sheamus called and told him not to, you know, this guy, they told him Coffee was getting tired and not to overwork himself. So I think he's taking a little break right now.
Nice counter by McDonough. Coffee with a left hook.
I think Sheamus now should start working. You know, it's all right to take a break, but now he's taking a break a little too far.
Is it important to pick your spots?
Oh, yeah, but I think that these body shots that Coffee was throwing, it's starting to take their toll. I think Sheamus should work the body also. But like I said, those left hooks will eventually begin to take their toll. As you see Sheamus' legs, they don't have to bounce like he had earlier.
You're watching professional boxing from Atlantic City. Yeah!